We the millennium. You come to take this game and bring it to me. We gonna be here. I ain't no fly-by-night nigga. Gonna be here 2 years, 3 years. I got this shit.
I met Baby and Slim. I was DJing in the Calio, and that's way out of my area. But every week, the drug dealers had me there because they wanted to keep that crowd out there. Baby and them was there. He was just like, I want to make records. And I think, like, you're the dude, you know, that could bring it to the next level. I think Baby can sell space heaters in hell. This dude will give you a speech, and y'all could be down by 100 points. And he can make your ass believe that you're going to win that game. Now, at the time, they had an artist called Kilo G. And I'm going, that's cool, but Bounce is popular right now. Let's try a Bounce record and see what happens. I heard about these dudes from my dad called UNLV. They was just like three little dudes that would just go around rapping off of breakbeats or whatever, but they had a following.
You know, it was only like three different record labels in New Orleans, and it was one of them, and they was trying to get the label off the ground, and we wasn't even in the studio. We recorded our first album in Mannie Fresh kitchen, matter of fact. Every album that we had done a lot of numbers. You know, we done real well with them. We opened the doors for them to sign other artists, added a little more revenue, and what we was doing differently, using the Bounce tracks, but we was putting gangsta lyrics on top of it.
What was different about Cash Money was we were telling stories with our Bounce. We had the catchy beats or whatever, but it was more of a reality Bounce.
Baby and Slim, what do you remember of that relationship? Like, did they have different roles in Cash Money?
What I can say about them, they know how to pick talent. Oh my God, bro, they have a gift. Baby and Slim, they always was looking for new artists. You know, we had UNLV for a long time, but it was, you know, like it's time for a new little era.
We knew what time it was. I think it was like a part of Baby and Slim's strategy to almost recreate a UNLV, but also add more to the company.